The Kennesaw State Field Station, managed by the Office of Research, is a 25-acre property located along Interstate 75, approximately 2 miles from the Kennesaw campus. A field station is a facility with a large piece of land that is dedicated to understanding the Earth through research and teaching.
So I'm Michael Blackwell, I'm the operations manager of the KSU field station, formerly known as the Hickory Grove Farm, but once we were transferred to the Office of Research, it's now been renamed the Kennesaw State University Field Station. So the field station is where we conduct agricultural experiments. We have students coming out to do all sorts of field research. It's basically a natural lab. So anything, ecology, biology, anyone that can utilize a natural area, that's what we're here for. So almost anything that relates to a natural setting.
So as a human geographer, we look at the relationship between people and the physical environment and how that relationship both shapes the environment around us and in turn, in many ways, shapes us. And I think there is an increasing awareness of the urgency of creating a new and sustainable relationship with the world in which we live. Climate change and the global water crisis are two of the most urgent issues. And so for us, I think as a community here at KSU, finding ways to both learn about sustainability globally, but also practice sustainability as a community, I think those are crucial.
Importance of sustainability, in my opinion. Well, there's been no shortage of unsustainable things that have happened in the world. And one of the great things about a site like this is it gives us an opportunity to show more sustainable approaches to anything, virtually. So how someone could manage water in their homes or growing their own food. So most people don't realize that 90% of the food that comes out of the United States comes out of the Central Valley of California. That is not a sustainable approach. So it doesn't mean that a person has to grow a large percentage of their food, but we can show people how to grow a small amount. Maybe it's your favorite vegetable. Anything that you can do to reduce the mileage traveled by our food is a more sustainable approach.
Through the field station, it is Kennesaw's goal to build and support sustainable communities.
I think there are a couple of areas that we're really addressing and doing well in. We have the energy and water dashboard at KSU that helps us look at those resource uses. We have the Office of Sustainability is looking at doing a deep dive into recycling right now and seeing how we can improve those processes. We have groups, student groups like OwlSwap, who are looking to address our use of textiles on campus and how do we become more sustainable in that use. So I think we're doing a lot of great things, but we have a long way to go. I think that solar energy is something that we should be delving into, and I think we're starting to look at that, so that could be an exciting area of development for KSU.
So there's already some fantastic projects going on. I mean, I think one of the most exciting ones is the composting of the food waste from the KSU Commons. I'm teaching geographies of sustainable agriculture this summer, and my class is designing a food forest, which is going to be located just right over there. We're really excited about that.
A food forest is a permaculture system that incorporates perennials and annual crops. And Jason Rhodes, who is a lecturer at KSU, and myself, we are creating a 1/8 of an acre food forest at the KSU field station. And it takes a couple of years to develop. But once it's created, it will be a model for urban communities to see sustainable and productive agriculture on a very small piece of land that they can potentially replicate in their communities, particularly low-income communities. And we hope to actually be able to offer agriculturalists and these small communities a way to come and get certifications here at the food forest.
KSU's field station is constantly researching ways to make sustainability more than a word, but an action. Their current projects include mushroom cultivation, a forensic anthropology field lab, urbanization effects on birds, and chestnut tree restoration. With all of these current projects, student involvement is crucial.
How do we get more students engaged in this, in the field station and in sustainability? One of the concerns I have is that students don't know that the KSU field station exists. And if they know, they don't realize how close it is to campus. I mean, it's literally just a 5-minute drive from campus. I think that the field station is working on that. The Office of Research is working on that. Obviously, faculty through their classes can get their students involved. So I think there needs to be more information out there about the field station and what's happening.
I used to teach a course here, which was organic agriculture and beginning apiary studies, beekeeping. And I was always surprised whenever I would have the first day of a class, we'd bring students in and we'd take them into the greenhouse. And it was a curious exercise to look at something that I see every day and I know what that vegetable is and ask that class, does anyone know what this is? And I was surprised that sometimes 75 to 80% of the people could look at a carrot growing and not know that it was a carrot because the edible portion is below ground. And so it just looks sort of like a fern. So exposing people to those things and understanding that you can do that is huge and very impactful for people.